And here are your hosts, James Dickman and Nikki Winster.
Right, audience, ladies, gentlemen, kids, this our humble assembly hall. Oh, welcome. Although we have but scarce an hour to act on play with all our power, we pray and bear with us through our shortcomings. The story is simple, it's told before. By William Shakespeare, our version's better. It's short and sweet, it's maybe couplets and goes with pieces. The setting is Denmark, the land of bakery. Capital city is Copenhagen. But then, I bore your ears with petty details, and I'm not one for the market retail.
So on with the plate,
then. If you like it a lot, just give it the ring.
But before we go, let us your mind to you and to the characters we are making for a
few. It may be helpful to understanding as Shakespeare's play are so demanding.
The prince, he knows how that will make you weep. For he struts and frets and talks to himself, he will woman who left on the shelf.
And talking of women, this is his mother. He lost her husband and married his brother, Queen of Denmark. Her name is Gertrude.
The singing knight, she's really quite beautiful. And this is her husband, Denmark the Boss. It's him that caused the aggro and made Hamlet cross. For he killed Hamlet's father, then made himself king, then married Hamlet's ma. Oh, to do what a thing.
So now to Ophelia, Polonius the daughter. Fair and most beauteous, Hamlet will court her. Though she's young, she's oft rather sad, vague, and so scatty. By the end, she's mad.
Ophelia, Polonius, her father we toss. Though Secretary of State, he's as green as the grass. Ready with Claudius, he holds his head high. And when he's not being advisor, he's acting as a spy.
And last of all, we look at Laertes, not only the son. He's rather too serious, not really much fun.
So on with the play for the play to sing.
We'd better get off or we might start to sing.
Oh, for a muse of fire that would ascend the brightest heaven of invention. A kingdom for a stage, princes to act, and monarchs to behold the swelling sea. Hello, I'm the chorus, the announcer, if you know what I mean. Although it's a small part, appearances have I many. On and off, off and on. I turn up, just like a bad penny. I come to set the scene, no less, no more. So here we are then, Act One. Scene One, the battlement at Elsinore.
Water and cement, I am most sure.
What say you, Francis?
Francisco.
Aye, sir.
Francisco, say you are.
Aye, sir. Aye, sir.
Then your eyes confirm what your eyes have seen.
A very good day to the party. Thank you, man.
I thank you, Marcellus. His timing fair, in the way I tell him. But stop. Who goes there? Friend or foe?
It's hard to tell. I do not know.
He's trying to pace it very slow.
Is it he or who you boast?
You run out of the to go.
And now the ratio, gentlemen, and the child.
In truth, Bernardo, I've been seeing a ghost. My eyes made sensible to see the certain minus between your ghost and Hamlet's past king. What say you, Francisco?
I, sir. I say I am most positive in my detection. The young foe, I cannot be delighted. It is extravagant in every manner to fit the gate of personal
knowledge. You have certainly.
Aye, sir. Aye.
All right. You are most royally and extravagantly certain. But stop. The ghost comes again, thither.
Thither comes the ghost again, thither, my lord.
Thither comes the ghost, thither. Speak, how you serve of the night. Impart your lofty purpose. Unnatural spectre. I charge you, speak.
I fear it, aren't you not, Horatio?
Aye, sir, I fear that too.
Speak, I charge you, speak, dark fiend's name is rude.
It is most poorly offended. You know the soul's way, the portion's change.
Speak, I charge you, speak. King, that special bow. Just say a word or two, into this microphone.
It's lit, quivers. Speak, it's going to speak.
No!
Hamish react. What will be his thought? From the battlements then, we pass now to the court. And so we bid you welcome to our court, fair cousins, Gertrude, Polonius, Laertes, and Hamlet.
We thank you, good king.
It's not long since Hamlet's father passed away, but we must our grief. There's a lay. You should be cheerful, come on, good cheer. I married Gertrude. Come, let's have a beer.
It is with heavy hearts I join the celebrations. I distrust the king and his evil machinations.
And now, Laertes, what's the news with you?
Having come to Denmark to see your coronation and witness to Gertrude your sweet collaboration. I pray you, cousin, gentle lord, give me leave to return to France.
I give you leave most ceremonious. But what says your dad, fair Polonius?
I say go, come must he do. Be good and not uncouth.
Come now, young Hamlet. Come take a cup. Your face looks down, you seem fed up.
Fair Claudius, I am despairing and much depressed. I think of my father, alas, no more, and blessed.
Father,
then
she's still got your mother.
Tis true, and Gertrude is the fairer sex. I love like Oedipus and his complex.
Don't mourn so, with unmanly grief. You're trembling like a fragile leaf. Such behaviour unbecomes a man, who, as Prince of Denmark, must learn to carry the can. And learn to speak in lines that scan. Come, Adam, lead the way. Hamlet's whinging gets me down. Let's crop a pint of Newky Brown.
How weary, stale, flat and unprofitable. Unprofitable, flat, stale and weary seem to me all the uses of this world. To put this another way, for in plain English I seldom speak, I feel so cross. I'm at a loss for words. 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 My dear mum, Gertrude, seemingly so fair and yet so lewd, marrying Claudius when poor father lies as deep in the earth. I cannot understand it. It's beyond my youthful comprehension. What has she done and what is her intention? Let me not think on it. Women, they're all the same. Frailty is their name. Why, gentle Horatio, friend and mate.
I think you've been worried. Sorry, I'm late.
What news, Horatio? I read much excitement in your face.
Aye, sir. A pretty excitement, which my son will unlock. Prepare yourself, Hamlet, that you're in for a shock.
Why speak then, Horatio? I charge thee, speak.
Your father, sir. I think I saw him in the battlements.
In the battlements? You must be dreaming.
I tell the truth. I swear I'm not seeing him. He appeared in the guise of his form, in the midst of the night. Happened so suddenly, it gave me a fright.
Pray, dear friend. Are you sure you've got this right?
Aye, sir. I am as positive in my assertion.
What say you, Marcellus and Bernardo?
We say aye, sir.
You say aye?
Aye, sir. We say aye.
Then it is right that my father did fright ere the night.
Most meet and right, did that right? It was the most cruelly dispensed ere the night.
The frightful night, most nightly in the depth of night, you sight. Did appear in the cold the blight. You did right, Horatio, to blight mine ears with this news most unfortunate. Come, let's the battlements repair, see if that's still there.
Sister. thou dost do me wrong. Here's fickle and fickle, they do pole. But thou dost not touch him, the pole must use it on barges. Like his fair handle, may I do? As princes go, he's not a bad bloke. His body, too witty, far from being broke. But he's young, Ophelia, and youth is but a fickle age. In the book of life, it's the very first page. Yet to bear the imprint of nature's ravaged hand, which writes the life with joyous tears, whence from experience flows, there's not a mark or a story of statue. Therefore distrust his tender looks, for they may turn sad in the crane of the cock. I am surprised that this comes as a shock. Better than to be shocked than sorry. On this note of contentious falling, I must be off, fair in the morning. My presence here means my absence off in France. I must away to Dover before the season is from here. Farewell, Ophelia. Take good care of me. And mark my words concerning Hamlet and his future master. His words in my heart strike a bitter blow. Can it be the Hamlet I love and know?
Your words, though wise, you strike a deep chord in my heart. as carps so hungrily to others themselves attach, must fathers not be cruel since they be
kind. Oh, Father, you're right. Hamlet must be
utterly
kind.
Thank you.
advise that we can settle around the court, that the prince's noble mind amounts to naught. Could you tell me, kind sir, the chief investigator, is Hamlet mad? Is he off his perambulator?
Your man can say what is the matter. I can say he's not mad as a hatter. Yet it must be said the prince's mind is in disarray. I told Ophelia to keep away. Indeed, I fear my lord having troubled mind stems from his love for Ophelia, friend and father.
Then
it's his
friend. It's his
family.
I thought
my
wife's lover.
I imagine you speak most truthfully. Hamlet is a fallen man in love, strangely transformed from hope to love.
What evidence have you on this unnatural mechanism?
A letter?
A letter?
Aye, sir, a letter, a billing too. Pick up your ears, kind sirs, how read you words writ by the minted mind. If he be not mad, then I am not.
Your words, sir, read, I beseech you.
Very well. My dearest Ophelia Cruz, for this is how he addresses her. This tender night, I think of your lips, and I will bring you, were it not for the pits. So I have written a billet doux in form of a poem, just for you. It's been a hard day tonight, and I've been working like a dog. It's been a hard day tonight. I should be sleeping like a log. But when I get home to you, I find the things that you do will make me feel all right. You know I work all day to get you money to buy you things, and it's worth it just to hear you say you're gonna give me everything. So why I have to come home, 'cause when I get you alone, you know I'll feel okay. When I'm home, everything seems to be right. When I'm home, fear me, holding me tight, tight, yeah.
What can this mean? Does this rhyme contain some hidden profundity?
No, sire. This rhyme is flattered, stupid, and cute. If you ask me, my liege, it has screwed loose.
Come, my good queen. All talk of Hamlet makes me sick in the belly. Let's see if there's anything good to watch on the telly.
Well meant, though this is madness, yet there is method in it. I leave you to your book, fair Hamlet, and bid you fond farewell. His ghost will never get a top billing. This lad's definitely short of a shilling.
Ah, my ruse it works. He is quite convinced I'm a man of the head. But stop! Who comes here? Why now, it's not my very ordinary schoolfellows, Rosencrantz and Guildenstern. How goes it, fair Rosencrantz and gentle Guildenstern?
We are quite well, fine sir and mate. The king tells us you're only in spirits of late. It's all a load of utter lies. The king sent us here as spies.
Indeed, I am most excellent in health. And I know that here myself. A little touch of Harry the Knight, but apart from that, I'm quite all right.
Rather more than a little Harry of the Knight, by all accounts.
That's good.
We are most pleased.
Pray tell me, is it true the players are in town?
Aye, sir, it is true.
Then could you kindly fix a rendezvous? I'd like to meet those actors fair. I have a play for them to prepare.
Your wish is our command, kind Hamlet. Wait till the king hears of this. We bid you fond farewell.
Windy upstart.
This play I'll get the actors to perform is one from my imagination board, a parable which tells the story of poor father's murder. It'll make him wince, it'll make him shudder. His bended ear will tilt, till render his death with guilt. Indeed, the play's the thing, wherein I'll catch the conscience of the king.
Strange, wasn't it? Hamlet's antics and all that business with the letter.
Look, I'm sorry about the jokes. Promise
they get better. Anyway, Rosencrantz and Guildenstern, having seen Hamlet in inverted commas mad, go now to inform King Claudius, who, as you all know, is a bounder and a cat.
Pray tell me, Rosencrantz and Guildenstern, is Hamlet really mad?
I suspect.
Not
so. Aye, sir, that's what I suspect too.
He is hurt, partial mad.
He is but mad, not
for worse. When we suddenly the most awful man.
His madness then is craftily put on.
Aye, sir, he most craftily put it on.
This fellow Hamlet then might be a danger to our state, if what you say is right. Polonius, what thinkest thou?
I think he mad or laughing about it.
Fair and beauteous Ophelia could render us a service to test out and confirm your premise. Let her then Hamlet meet and see if she's still right up his street.
I fear the Lord this might not work. I thought that Hamlet was a burk. She's all this beauteous and I'm revived now. See what I can do, then at least I'm proud.
Prithee, make me haste. Hamlet approaches at great speed. Let us withdraw.
To be. Or not to be? That is the question. Whether 'tis nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune, or to take arms against a sea of trouble and by opposing, end it. To die, to sleep, no more, and by our sleep to say we end the heartache and the thousand natural shocks that flesh is heir to. 'Tis a consummation developed, we wish. To die, to sleep perchance to dream.
Death for us.
For in that sleep of death, what dreams may come when we have shuffled off this mortal coil must give us pause. There's the respect that doth make calamity of so long a life. For who would bear the whips and scorns of time, the oppressor's wrong, the proud man's contumely, the pangs of disprise of love, the insolence of office, the law's delay, and the spurns, the patient merit of the unworthy chase, when he himself might as quiet as make with a bare bodkin. Who would follow there to grunt and sweat under a weary life, but that the fear of something after death, that undiscovered country, from whose bourne no traveller returns, puzzles the will, and makes us rather bear those ills that we have than fly to others that we know not of. Thus, does conscience make cowards of us all?
know the reason why. In the morning, I wanna die. In the evening, I wanna die. If I ain't dead already, woo! Girl, you know the reason why.
Your hard pictures. The play is good, better than the pictures. Come, gentlemen.
show, as he's rather enjoyed the last one, albeit rather slow.
Most royal Claudius, and most royal and beauteous Gertrude, sagacious Polonius, and dear, beautiful Hamlet.
Enough introductions. If brevity be the soul of wit, heaven's sake, Anne, get on with it.
Kind gentlemen all, we produce our mind, about a file, and healer's prize.
Yes, indeed. Much better than the flit. This shows a complete and utter fit. It points the conscience of the king to prick, and reminds him of what he did to that. Just watch the king, he'll get much mad. I kill the impulses on the lines of heaven, his soul will join the virtue stone. I want him rid of this sacred shell, that he may die and go to hell. Foul Claudius, you are spared, but temporarily. I do not kill you now, but I will kill you, presently.
Amen. I must go now, and with my wife rejoice.
It's quiet now, and I swear I heard a voice.
Hamlet has come to impart some words to our fair queen. This whole thing is quite a trial. I'm here as Claudius, espy. Cross off, hither they come from thither. I'll hide myself behind this screen. From thence, can I hear, but can't be seen. By the way, fair audience, in Shakespeare, this screen's an arras, but I will not with Dr. Wilkins in that.
Thank you.
question. Whether 'tis nobler in the mind to take arms against the sea of troubles.
Kind audience, they'll probably expect us now on some speaking
phrase or lofty soliloquy. But bereft I am of spit, and my alas, at living, alas, once so felicitous, is not what it used to be. Or not to be, that is the question. Methinks I'm in a mess alone in the stage. Acting's no fun when you get to my age. But stop! I think I'm safe, my God, I thank it. Rosencrantz and Guildenstern, you are the US cavalry.
Fire, in tidings, great song.
The good way until tomorrow. Speak then, I charge you, speak.
Polonius, my lord.
He's dead, my lord. In bed.
No, sir.
Dead.
Aye, sir, dead. The sleep of the spoken doorman.
He has, my lord, surveyed and kicked out the
bucket. My lord. He has six sousses. Enough, fair lord. Now labour to the point.
For my methods are well managed, which was a point, both Polonius died.
Aye, sir, the point of Hamlet's sword, not to put too fine a point on it.
Ha 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 ha! Being very quick and goodly firm, good old Gilbert, you're really rather fun.
But what is the point of all this?
Very good, sir.
No, you misunderstood my name. Tell me straight in meaning's pain, what happened? Pretty tell me again.
I'm in Cyclopolis, in the Arabs.
In the Arabs?
Oh, quite painful it was too.
Oh, shut up, Ogilvy, with your noisy chatter. This is an affair most serious, no laughing matter. Hamlet is dangerous and must be punished. In exile I'll put him, to England he's banished. Come in, the fair servants, come, listen to me. Put him on a boat for England, R&G.
Go, most humbly, sire.
Brave indeed is where poor Polonius soon shall be.
You've heard
the
report,
what is it
already?
I'm from R&G, Danish born, Cyndi
Lauper.
Don't tell me she too has died tonight.
No, sir, look where they are. You speak for solid. You get mad, sir. Stop a choice.
Not a bad one. First it's Hamlet, now it's Ophelia. Is there not one parent named in Denmark who's saying?
She speaks for large. Good to say. Quite a mess. Hear out. It's quite a mess. Stop!
Right. Where is he?
Whom do you speak, bold man?
Polonius!
My father! Where is he?
Dead, my lord.
Ah, dead. And like you shall be. Present.
Here, Laertes, when you got that sword around, hold myself together and calm myself down.
It was not I who did the murder.
Tis who then, tis who, Laertes? I, tis who.
It was Hamlet who did the murder.
What? Hamlet? Prince of Denmark? That little titch. I'll kill him for this, I mean, son of a... It was not Laertes Hamilton that should kill your father. Sweet for a man himself, and board an ocean ship. This is Troll, his cruel face. The fair queen just think around killing people by accident. Oh, I'll have him for this, with death he bartered by this sword in my hand. I'll have him gut for garters. But so, who comes thither?
Discover, and when he's down, he'll never recover. just to make absolutely sure, him to our next viewer, I'll put some poison in his cup. When he's tired, he's sure to suffer.
Ha! That could get him in a nasty little pup.
But stop, who comes here?
It is us, sir. Rosencrantz?
I'm here, Mr. What news do you bring? I charge you to speak.
I'm here, two gold, sir.
Get to the point, don't pull up on her.
One, Ophelia's dead, sir. She has drowned.
Two, look out, everybody.
Hamlet's in there. Right. Oh, get him.
But pray, keep it quiet.
and quite complete. This your good girl, Far, got a nervous attention.
Why then, tell me then, sir, joke most hilarious.
It's long enough to laugh at myself.
It's quite so hilarious.
Very well then. Well, already. Not. Thou must reply, who's there? We'll try it again. Now this one, beware.
No.
Who's there?
Chester.
Ha ha, very funny.
No, when I say Chester, thou must reply, Chester who?
Joe too complex as its invention. For it relies on the complicity of the listener. But pretty, let us start this again.
No.
Who's there?
Chester
who?
Chester day. Oh, my trouble sits so far away.
And that's not all. Oh dear.
We're sticking here. But pray continue, friend. Start it to me.
Knock.
Who's there?
Amos.
Amos who?
Amos Eno.
Me thinks thou art most unfunny. But that, who come here?
Desperation. He's got it. Make a letter.
Come thou to visit she who did rant and rave. We bid you, sir, welcome to our grave.
Alas, woe is me, me's woe. For I did truly love Ophelia, although I did not know. Prithee tell me, good clown, who is this here hither?
Tis the son of God.
Alas! Poor Yorick! I knew him, Horatio.
Really?
What was he here?
It was a comic, a funny court jester, an early form of Charlie the Chester. Alas, he is no more. His skull and bones lie in the floor. To all befalls the aforesaid fate. Life's not just a bowl of cherries in a plate. My father, Ophelia, the king and Georgie Best, to all and sundry comes this place of rest. Even old Alice the Great, the taller, how hath the mighty fallen. But look at the time, it's getting rather late. We'd best be off, for the Laertes have I made date. Why, I bid you welcome, my good Laertes.
I thank you for your welcome. Your return of this is not but rather speak, your friend, back. I disgrace you, and that you murdered my dad.
Let me be your friend and not your quarry. Okay, I murdered your dad, but I said I was sorry.
Say what you will. I accept not your apology. You're a bad man, Hamish, hath no desire for astrology. Be less
dismayed.
I pity one favour.
I'll do anything, Laertes. I'll even vote Labour. Prithee, state my request. I'm here at your behest.
I've made peace, Lord, a small old bond there. But if by sword, I'll win the game, match and play. Kill the land to ask for, and all the best courses to buy me six of the country's best horses.
Well, come, let's do it ere you come on the boil. Pretty good, Horatio. Go fetch me my foil. King Claudius, your worship, your eminence. Prithee, do watch us. We're going to fence.
Hamish,
I hope you ought to ask for better. For in order to win, you've got to get three. If you're tired, we won't stop for tea. Instead, we will sup Chateauneuf, 53. Hammond is their native employee.
Very well, dear uncle, friend, coach and spectator. Let the fight commence. Let's join our ringside commentator.
Referee's having none of it, but Leo is still going on. Doesn't like it. And there's the end, Mark. There's the cookie for the outfit. Well, one player is always going to their glory.
But then again, too few to mention. did what I had to do, and so I'm through without exception. I plan each charted course, each careful step along the mile. But more, much more than this, I did it my way. Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I bit off more than I can chew. But through it all, when there was doubt, I ate it up and spat it out. I faced it all. I find it all so amusing. To think I did all that, and may I say, not in a shy way. Oh no, not me.
Into my car, now you're my angel divine, you're 16. Ooh,